Right. So let's talk about, give me an overall situation right now.
Okay, well, like what you said in the beginning of the show, the PNR's Metro Manila line was temporarily closed. Ano? And temporary here is a five-year hiatus. We plan to continue or restart operation after the construction in 2028. There are challenges. Ano? One of them is the...
Wait, how many commuters are affected by the closure of the line?
Well, it's between 25,000 to 30,000 daily.
Wow.
And that is why we have deployed the buses, alternative buses that will fly along the affected routes of the PNR in the stations and in different areas where our passengers normally would go. No? So there's good news and bad news. Of course, we'd like to start with the ano, with the obvious challenges. No? Mas mahal ng konti ang pamasahe sa bus, but konti lang naman. However, the good news is that these buses that we deployed, they're able to go to the different areas where our commuters would normally go down to. No? So like if they want to go to the Divisoria Mall, for example, then they don't have to take two buses or tricycle to go to the palengke. No? They just have to take the bus and the bus would stop directly in these areas, in these affected routes.
Oo. Pero more than that, kahit may bus, magbabago ang schedule din ng mismong pasahero. Kasi mas mabilis ang tren eh.
True. Magbabago po yung schedule. Pero yung mga buses namin during rush hours, we are running every 15 minutes. No? Which means that yung kabilang...
How many buses, sir, have been deployed?
Currently, we have 25 buses that were that are running in all of these areas. In fact, okay. Ma'am Karen,
private buses that you've commissioned, or they are new buses owned by the PNR for 5 years?
This is one company that was given an emergency franchise by the LTFRB to accommodate our passengers. The one company has deployed 25 buses. I did my inspection last week for 2 days. I went to several stations and I went to the routes that our passengers would normally go to. Nakita ko, ma'am, the 25 buses is actually enough because in the morning, during rush hours, every 15 minutes, dumadaan yan. Ano? And during the day, during off-peak hours, every 30 minutes dumadaan yung mga buses. So our ano, our commuters, I think ano, and this is according to on the ground inspection that I did ano, I think our passengers are served well with the bus augmentation program.
Okay. Now, other than that, we also have residents that will be affected by the railway project, and they need to be relocated, no? So how many residents are in Barangay 349 because their homes have to be demolished? Take us through this. I mean, masalimuot po ito. So ilan
Totoo, ma'am.
Pa, ilan ang pamilya sa Barangay 349?
Okay, well, I do not know exactly kung ilan, no? However, two things that are important, no? The right-of-way issues on the areas affected, no? Ginawa po natin yan in Pampanga and in Bulacan. In fact, the Pampanga to Bulacan route from Clark all the way to Metro Manila na kayo, Valenzuela City, no? Which is very near Bulacan. That route is about close to 90% finished, which means lahat po ng ROW, right-of-way issues dito sa area na to, was taken care of. And ang utos ni President Marcos and also Secretary Jimmy Bautista is to move the people to the same city or province where they were moved out of. Let's say, for example, if you are from Bulacan, ililipat ka sa Bulacan din. If you are from Pampanga,
But let's talk about ito, yung Barangay 349, yung nakatira doon. So you don't have the number right now.
I suppose this is in Metro Manila, right, ma'am?
Opo, well, nakalagay, well, I'm assuming too, but it's not detailed here. Pero i-assume na natin, kasi it's numbered Barangay 349, no? So there are houses and establishments, not all homes, okay? I mean, clearly national interest takes precedence. That's a given.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
We need to do the railway project. So, una, do you have a schedule for the demolition?
Well, we have already started fencing activities and track removal activities. The next would be construction. And obviously, we cannot construct without doing the talking and demo and coordinating, you know, with the soon to be displaced settlers. That's why the president created the executive order, and he put together a group of cabinet secretaries, you know, to resolve the issue. And PNR, our agency, being the lead department that will talk, go down to the ground and talk directly to the the affected people. Ma'am, meron tayong budget for renovation
purposes. Have you gone down to the ground? Have you spoken?
Yes.
Okay, so just give me an overview. Per family, how much is the budget of the government to move them out? Because at the end of the day, you will be demolishing their home. So that amounts for something. Hindi lang yun ilalagay sila sa isang probinsya. I'm sure there's a cash outlay of some sort. So magkano per family?
Yan po ngayon ang pinag-uusapan at dinidesisyonan. Pero ma'am, dahil matagal na itong project na to at matagal na itong pinag-uusapan, meron na pong mga ginagawang mga alternative settling facilities, no, para sa kanila. We have coordinated with the DSUD and also with the National Housing Authority to build the settlement where we will move them to, no? Not only in Metro Manila but also in Laguna. And you have to remember, we did this in Pampanga and in Bulacan. So this is an ongoing process which started 3 years ago. And now, and then in the future. That is why I am very confident, ma'am, that this process will be taken care of and that the target, you know, as set forth by the president will be met. And this is in 2028, babalik ang PNR, which is stronger and better than before, will be able to show the Philippines, you know, the most modern railway system, which is at par with world standards, no? Whatever we're seeing in neighboring countries like Hong Kong, Japan, Singapore, is the same railway system that we're doing and building here in the Philippines.
No, and frankly speaking, we need it.
We need it very much so.
There's no debate. There's no debate. We need it. In fact, we needed it yesterday. Right?
When it
comes to rail, the Philippines needed it yesterday. But
I don't have enough time,
but here's the last question.
Sure.
Karen, please ask Mr. Macapagal, will the government have a subsidy for cheaper fares? I'm not familiar with just how different the fare is from the PNR now to the bus, right? So, anong is it possible to make it equal? Pwede ba yun? Parang no loss, no profit. Pareho lang.
Oh, ganito ma'am eh. The train system, the PNR, no, is government subsidized. That is why currently we are the cheapest mode of transportation compared even to the tricycle and to the jeepneys, you know, that ply the streets of Metro Manila. Now, the buses that we have deployed, these are private buses. No? Yeah. That is why they are not subsidized by the government. Pero, ang sabi ko naman, no, please use the lowest available metric system, which is why mababa din naman eh. Ang difference lang is only 40 pesos. It's 50 pesos.
40 pesos a day ang difference?
No, from end to end. From end to end. Kasi ang umpisa po dyan, Tutuban, Matatapos po yan in Alabang. No? Yeah. So it's only 41 to 42 pesos ang difference sa pambasahe. But, no, this,
end to end.
Yes, ma'am. Now, these buses are comfortable, they're aircon, and they go to the streets or to the areas where our trains cannot go to. Which means, ma'am, in a way, parang na yung taas ng konti na ano rin na na-overcome din dahil nakakapunta yung mga buses in the areas kung saan malapit talaga bababa yung mga pasahero namin. You have to remember, limited lang ang ano, sa station to station lang pag PNR, no? And also, ma'am, once this is finished, we should be able to transport 800,000 passengers daily. That's, absolutely, you know, compared that to 30,000, ang daming tao niyang matutulungan. Yeah.
Well, I think there's no need to sell the importance of improving our railway. I think that is a given. Ang tanong ko, last question, will President Marcos Jr., before he leaves office, will he be able to inaugurate the new train system? Maaabutan ba niya ito?
Magandang tanong po yan. Ito po masasabi ko, and I say this very confidently, no? The Clark to Valenzuela city line, ano? Yan, may inaugurate po yan. In fact, after the midterms, siguro in 2026, may inaugurate yan. Manila to Laguna, in some areas, yes, no? But the target is that we should be able to complete it. So what I'm saying is we will do our best. Yeah. To finish this by 2028, we should be fully operational. Pero kung may mag-inaugurate siya, definitely may inaugurate siya. This is, after all, a part of the president's flagship project. No? Yeah. And gusto natin na may pagmalaki ng ating mahal na Pangulo, no? Na natapos ito during his watch.
Okay, it would make such a difference to see something of this magnitude, frankly, be finished in the next 5 years. So thank you so much for joining me. I do hope you can come back on Head Start because I think we can discuss more as the days go on, right? This is a recurring issue in the next few days. So thank you so much, PNR Chairman Michael Makapagal. Thank you, sir.
Maraming salamat po, ma'am. I would love to come back. Thank you po.